Hey, how are you doing? Welcome to Miss Tech Hack. I also welcome you all to a new series on Kafka. Apache Kafka is an open source, distributed, event streaming platform. It combines messaging, storage, and stream processing to allow storage and analysis of both historical and real-time data. Its biggest advantage is it allows independent applications reading from data streams to work independently at their own rate, hence making the overall processing fast and scalable. Confused and wondering like why and how? Don't worry, I will cover it step by step to help you understand it with ease. The series will cover Kafka basics, project setup, and execution. So, if you are new to Kafka, this series will be very helpful to you. Or, if you know anyone willing to learn Kafka basics, do share and suggest this Kafka basics series to them. Today, in this video, we will see how Kafka works. But before we go ahead, make sure to subscribe to Miss Tech Hack so you don't miss on any of our updates and latest videos. So let's get started. To understand the flow of Kafka, we need a message queue, and subscribers. A message basically contains a header part and a payload part. Payload is passed as an avro, which is a serialization format for data defined using JSON. A message queue can contain multiple topics. A topic is a logical category of message. For example, a news channel can have topics like sports, politics, stock market, etc. Here, I have just taken it as topic 1, topic 2, topic 3, and topic 4. Subscribers are the one that can listen to a topic they have subscribed to, which means they receive messages from a subscribed topic. Here, I have taken two subscribers, subscriber 1 and subscriber 2. Now, suppose the message is sent to topic 1 and also topic 3. Subscriber 1 has subscribed to topic 1 and topic 2, while subscriber 2 has subscribed to topic 3. So, subscriber 1 will receive message from topic 1 and subscriber 2 will receive message from topic 3. Now, let's see the big picture. In real life example, to make it work, we need three components. Organization, Kafka cluster, and a consumer group. Organization is nothing but the client application that publish events to Kafka. That is the one sending the messages, which is called the producer. Here, I have taken three producers, producer 1, producer 2, and producer 3. To understand Kafka cluster, first understand what is a broker. A broker is a server that forms the storage layer that will receive and send the messages. And a Kafka cluster is a group of these broken nodes working together to provide scalability, availability, and fault tolerance. So here I have taken two brokers, broker 1 and broker 2. Kafka cluster also contains a zookeeper. Now, what is a zookeeper? It basically works as the central configuration and management system for Kafka. So it contains all the metadata about the cluster. Then we have consumer group. As the name suggests, it is a group of consumers acting as a single logical unit. And a consumer is the one that consumes or receives the message. So here I have taken three consumers, consumer 1, consumer 2, and consumer 3. The rectangular boxes in gray are the topics present, and it's further divided into partitions. Now both consumer groups and partitioning, both is used to implement scalability in Kafka. So when the vertical scaling threshold is reached, we do horizontal scaling. So we split data of a topic into multiple streams. We call these smaller streams partition of that topic. Now the flow is simple. The producers send over data, that is messages, to the Kafka cluster, that is to the topics, and consumer will consume the messages from these topics. So we have seen the different components used in Kafka and how the message flow works in Kafka. That's it for this video. I hope you find it useful. For any queries or concerns, write me down in the comment section. Thank you so much. Have a great day.